Hello, Marin County enthusiasts. I get lots of calls about low-priced, affordable homes and land in Marin County. In this video, I'll give you the lowdown on why most of the super low prices don't work for most people. And I'll also dive into Marin's most affordable homes, those without a catch. Hang on to the end, where I'll tell you a little-known fact that could easily lead to more affordable housing in the near future. So let's get to it. Hi, I'm Carrie Hill, lawyer turned realtor, and I've lived in Marin County for nearly 30 years and raised three children here. If you're a buyer or seller in Marin County, I'd love to help you make a smart move. Just email me on to affordable houses. What am I going to consider affordable for the purpose of this video? How about $500,000? I know that's not affordable for most people, but considering the average home price in Marin County over the past year was about $1.75 million, I think $500,000 is a pretty decent price. So let's start there. Before I get into the types of homes and locations of where most affordable homes are, let me address some specifics about the calls I get. One, cheap condos. I often get calls about condominiums available for sale under $200,000. Yes, those do exist, but by and large, the catch is that those are condos that are located in senior citizen locations, meaning you can't buy there unless you are at least 55 years old. Additionally, these homes often have huge HOA fees, like all those condos on Thorndale Drive in San Rafael that have been in nearly every one of my videos that showed current homes with a reduced price. Anyway, those fees at that Thorndale location, they're about $4,000 a month. So they do include a lot of great amenities, like there is one chef's cooked meal per day, housekeeping, 24-hour security, and some medical care. Long story short, people who call me under the age of 55 years old do not qualify to live in these condominiums under $200,000. And chances are, they don't want to pay those high monthly fees either. Two, cheap land. I also frequently get calls about land available in Marin under the price of $100,000. So here's the bottom line with those. They usually aren't buildable, or at least not easily buildable. For example, there's a property that went pending just this week on Fire Road in Woodacre. It was listed for $49,000. The catch? The soils report highlights that the land won't accommodate a septic system. No septic system? No building permit. However, a workaround would be to go to a neighboring home and offer money to hook up to their septic system. Of course, there's tons of reasons why that could be difficult, but it is a potentially viable solution that would then make the land buildable. Three, super cheap homes. When you see a beautiful home pictured on Zillow, but the price is obviously really low for the area, what's the catch? One of two situations. One, it's really just land, and the picture you're seeing is of some planned house that doesn't yet exist on that land. Two, it could be that it's super inexpensive because it's really a teardown home that you also can't live in. So now you have the expense of tearing down the home plus building another one. But altogether, it's still just land. Now you know why many of these really low-priced homes and land are not viable for most of us. So the first thing I want to show you is just how many homes sold in Marin County under $500,000 during this entire past year. Those are right here. And you can see that it's a pretty small amount compared to other areas in the Bay Area. So let's just talk about the ones that are currently for sale now. Let's start with this house right here. This house is $500,000. It's one bedroom, one bathroom, a very small 542 square feet. It's actually already been on the market for several months, which suggests that $500,000 isn't great. First of all, it is, you know, a floating home, and there is some lease expense to the dock. And now we're looking at a home in Forest Knolls, which is near Woodacre and Lagunitas. It's a really beautiful area. It's when you're going down Sir Francis Drake and everything opens up to looking like wilderness on your way to essentially the beach. Anyway, it's a beautiful area. You can see it's only $280,000. So what gives? Since it's two bedrooms, two baths, and 1,222 square feet. That's fairly good, right? But it's already been on the market for 58 days. Must be something. And now I'll have the actual description showing. And I'll tell you, this cabin that sits here, it's not habitable. So again, it fits into that group of homes that I mentioned at the beginning of this. You're really buying the land. Although sometimes what makes a home not habitable can be still overcome, probably at a great deal of expense. Okay, now we are getting into the type of property that is often available in Marin County for under $500,000, and that would be condominiums. This particular condominium is $380,000. It's in San Rafael in this location, which is a nice neighborhood. And by the way, remember these 13 homes, not going into those. Those are the ones in the senior housing area. So this one at 380 has two bedrooms, one bath, and 893 square feet. And it's been on the market already for 40 days, which suggests to me as an agent that you could probably get it for less than this cost. I'm now moving up to this Novato location near Ignacio, great area in Novato, which if you haven't seen it, you can check all these things out on my pros and cons of Novato or my downtown Novato walking tour. In any event, this is another condominium and it is $492,791, two bedrooms, one bath, 1,113 square feet, been on the market only 10 days. And I know this Oak Grove Drive, it's a really nice area of Novato and you can easily walk to like Nugget Market and a really great coffee place, Marin Coffee Roasters. So the other two places that are available here and I think it was just above here, they're both over $400,000 and they're both condominiums. This one's pretty small at 626 square feet compared to the other things we've already seen today. So you know that most of these are condominiums, but I know there's been other options too. So I'm gonna go back now to properties over the last year so I can show you a couple of more like locations that generally come up for lower priced homes, as well as the types of property, because yes, it's not impossible to get a single family home. Here are all those homes that sold in the past year. There were two out here. They were both in Lagunitas under $500,000, and both of them were single family homes that you could live in. Now this one at $265,000, it says right in the description of it, not for the faint hearted, that it's a rustic cabin. So it obviously needs some work, not your normal standard living. And the other one pretty much said the same type of thing. But my point is, you can find homes under $500,000 in Marin. It may be a lot like this, where they're fairly far out from the main going part of Marin, so not very easy to commute to San Francisco from. Those areas that are Woodacre, Lagunitas, Forest Knolls. And the other property type that we haven't discussed before are manufactured homes in Marin. So I want to talk about this one right down here in Larkspur. I represented the buyer on this property, so I know a lot about it. So this property that was right over in this mobile home park right here went for about $165,000, and it was a pretty new manufactured home too. So the catch to these manufactured homes when they sit in lots like this is that you have to also pay for the rental of your lot that your manufactured home is sitting on. Now this particular one that I represented the buyer on, it was owned by the owner of the mobile home park. And that was helpful because the current lot price was $1,450 a month, and I was able to negotiate that down to $950 for my buyer. I also got some money off of the asking price of the mobile home, so it worked out well. But you know what? This is a pretty amazing place. Now, I know a lot of you don't want to live in manufactured homes, and that's fine, but this is great living for those of you who don't mind. Like I said, first of all, the manufactured home was fairly new. And second of all, look where it's located. Let me zoom in here. This location is amazing. My client can just walk out the backside of her unit and walk on this levee that's right here, where you have views of the bay. pretty nice. And also, you can walk down this levee area and all the way down to the mall. So that would be over here. There you go. Oops, right there. It's a decent size walk, but really doable. It doesn't take that long. And my client could also walk out her door. You go down here, you can walk right over the overpass, down this a little bit to the ferry for Larkspur, which is right here, or across the street to Larkspur Landing, which has all kinds of nice shops. And speaking of shops, she could also go the other way, right over here, I mean, right there, to Trader Joe's, which is right there, and there's a Bevanmore and a Pier 1, and I think it's a vitamin store. Anyway, very, very convenient and a really nice walking area. I say that's pretty good for $165,000. And by the way, it was a two-bedroom manufactured home too. Nice kitchen, looked great, really. So for $165,000, that seemed like a pretty good deal. All right, I've seen a couple more deals like that in Marin, but not at quite this low of a price, more like $200, $225, and those are also in mobile home parks. And the rental is a big deal. You really have to look into that and make sure that that all works. So by the way, when somebody wants to get in a manufactured home, there are a few extra steps to doing that, which is that buyers of the manufactured home themselves must qualify to pay for the lot that's underneath it. And that means an extra application for the qualification of even living in the area. That part is the financial part, which many of them will have that you have to earn 3 times the income of the space cost that's under your manufactured home. A lot of them have other questions too. Obviously, manufactured home places all want quality people to live there. So there may be a couple other hoops that people have to jump through in order to buy a place in a manufactured home. Anyway, I think you have it now. You know what's available in Marin. It's going to be on the outskirts of the high traffic areas that are near Highway 101 if you want to find a home that's under $500,000. But there are manufactured homes and condominiums that also come available in Marin County. The future. Now to the facts about why Marin County will have more affordable housing in the future. One fact that is fairly well known, at least it's constantly in the news, and another fact that hardly anyone knows about. The well-known one is, of course, that Marin County has been mandated by the state to permit some 14,000 residences by 2031. A big chunk of those new residences must include housing for low-income residents. I suspect that housing will end up being allocated by lottery, just like other homes in Marin have been. But there's another fact that could easily result in low-priced housing that would be available for purchase by lower-income families and first-time homebuyers. That additional housing results from the ability of homeowners to put a detached ADU, which stands for accessory dwelling unit, on their property and then sell that ADU and the land underneath it. That's right. This state law, Assembly Bill 1033, took effect January 1st of this year, and it is about making more housing available for lower income and first-time homebuyers. However, this new law requires counties and cities to adopt it or it has no effect. But remember, counties and cities right now must come up with ways to meet the required extra housing that the state is mandating. Seems counties and cities could jump on adopting this additional way to meet their housing needs. Okay, that's a wrap. I hope this information was useful for you. If you'd like to learn more about Marin County or the buying and selling process, check out the videos which should be showing right now. Have a great day.